immediately to bring justice to this conference. So I thank God. I give all praises to him. He's the one that can make everything possible. After Barakot, what next is this conference? What's happening here today is divine. Let's not take it for granted. And I believe that this great man, this governor, prosperity in Georgia, that he has made a difference in the life of so many people. This conference is long overdue, but thank God there's a proverb in our culture. It is when a man wakes up that is his morning. I thank the governor that he has identified our money for us, and God Almighty will bless him. I thank him so much. Let me start by telling you that our job in the federal is to support the state. It's not to take away from the state. That's why we did some promotional items I'll be dividing very soon to support this program, to show truly that this program is very important. It's unfortunate that we've been paying lip service to this sector. And it's the only secret remaining, the only secret remaining to change the narrative of this great country. People talk about oil. Oil will finish someday. And what do we do? Oil is good. But culture and tourism is better. Because oil will finish someday. It's exhaustive. But culture and tourism is part of our life. I'm going to take on Benjamin for one or two things. I must commend you. Lovely talk. But there's something missing. A lot of you white people misunderstood me, black men and women. You, as you are sitting down there now, you don't know the difference between a Nigerian, a Ghanaian, a Togolese, a Cameroonian. So when anything happens, we all believe it's a Nigerian because it's a big, black African country in the world. Now, Benjamin, I must tell you, let us go back to the Treaty of the United Nations. 1979, June 14th. It says, and I quote, if you have to do business in any country, you go to the embassy of that country, from your own country, and take the cultural attaché. A lot of foreigners don't go to the attaché. They go to the wrong hands, and when they are doing it, they say they are Nigerians. Please, Nigerians are very great people, honorable people, distinguished people. But there could be some level of misunderstanding. Also, you talk about your visa. Right now, as of today, there is tourist visa in Nigeria. You take it at the airport on arrival. So some of these people mislead some of our friends on what's supposed to be. So I want to assure you that with the few things we'll be taking off here today, a change has come. And that change is total. Let me quickly take the aspect of culture and tourism, sustainable development. Tourism is movement of people from one place to the other. But you must stay 24 hours at that destination to make you a tourist. Unfortunately, they tried to deceive us, but some of us have refused. All the major airlines in the world fly to Nigeria. In fact, Emirates is now doing 2 flights to Nigeria a day. British Airways is doing 14 flights a week. Ethiopia Airlines is now doing 3 flights. Who are the people flying to Nigeria? And somebody will say, this country is not safe. I take an exception to that. It is absolutely a safe country. People have been talking for us. Will nobody allow to talk for us again? We want to speak for ourselves and tell people who Nigerians are. Because when we were coming, people were calling me, are you going to the pledge? Is it safe? Unfortunately, Benjamin, you mentioned communication. As we're in this hall now, NCAC is screening this event live. Just for your Facebook, it's still alive. If the plateau or just is not safe, we won't be here today. All we need to do is to communicate to the people that this country and plateau state is very, very safe. Unfortunately, it beats my heart. Plateau state is supposed to be our own Dubai. Benjamin, you will agree with me. There is a medical research that came up as far back as 1999. It's only Plateau State that have the sun and cold weather that had a particular ailment in the whole world. And when you see a lot of foreigners coming to Jos, not that they only like us, they've come for what I call medical tourism. It's medical tourism. Do you know that the apple being gotten in Plateau in Jos is better than the one got any part of Africa? And people come here to buy it and take it out of the other part of the world and sell it as their product. So I believe that Mr. Governor has opened a new chapter, has been able to give us an opportunity to talk to ourselves. I agree with representative of the DIG and Benjamin, the time has come, nobody will speak for us. We have to speak for ourselves and tell our stories. For a very long time, somebody will tell you your next door neighbor is not a good person. And you believe it. Tourism is about impacting on the people. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is the only sector that nobody is useless. Can you hear me?
Yes.
If you get F9, F9 in school, F9 plus, you are not useless in culture and tourism. You don't require a PhD to be a creative person. This is what it is for this country. I went to Dubai and I was told that the best bed spreader, he says, excuse me, can you hear me well?
Yes.
Do you know spreading on bed?
Yes.
They have to fly somebody from London to come and spread bed in Dubai. They say it's the best bed spreader in the world. And I asked for his salary, more than that of a PhD holder. We have a lot of them in Nigeria who can spread bed. Can I bring them? So, one sector that can reduce crime, unemployment, reduce even fighting ourselves. Why should we be fighting ourselves in a beautiful country like this? Ladies and gentlemen, some countries of the world, you can only come out only 3 months a year. God gave us 12 months plus, and we are fighting. Are we begging God to bring snow here? Disaster? Please, I'm pleading with all of us. Who tells you that an Igbo outside your back cannot live together? The biggest footballer who came out of this country. We're not from Plateau State here. I can name some for you. The Gambler of Oye, the Little Sule, the Achibola, and a lot of them. There was no discrimination. What is happening to us now? We need to talk to ourselves. Please, all over the world now, they have one strategy of developing their product. It's called the SWOT analysis. Strengths, weaknesses, opportunity, and threats. How can somebody come and be discussing the weakness of Nigeria with me? It is wrong. We also have some strengths. It's not that bad. That's why the DIG representative agreed with me. In 1972, there was a bomb attack in London, if you recall it. And the tourist statistics dropped by 64%. The British government came in with $2 million to hype it up, to communicate to the world. They know what they are using. We have no problem in Nigeria. What we have are challenges. And you cannot be a champion without having challenges. No success without struggle. You can never enjoy the benefit of good except you struggle for it. Let me stop deceiving us. I'm pleading. A lot of you will be surprised, but if you recollect, I am the one who led the peace concert to Plateau State after the crisis at the stadium here. And I came, I saw these are lovely people. The Christians and the Muslims here have been living together for so many years. So what is the problem? Somebody is pushing us to be against each other. Must we allow this to continue? Please, I have come to appeal to you. Plateau State can make the difference for this country. Dubai is not the capital of UAE, it's Abu Dhabi. But what Dubai is making today is servicing the other 7 states right now. If Plateau State is doing well, why can't it service other states? And all of us will be happy for it. I am praising today. I don't know how to pretend. If the governor does not know that God has used him for what happened here today, I will explain it. I don't know how to pretend. Some governors cannot sit down for 10 minutes to listen to what you make them. They are still better. And the outside man had it very simple. This conference is about asking, what can we do? And a man who is humble enough to ask questions from home and abroad, he has the best interest for the people of this state.